All right, in this one I wanted to quickly present the yazi file explorer. And so it's a terminal file explorer, and for a long time I was looking for a good one. And it was hard to find. Like, there was Ranger, which is written in Python, so a bit slow. Then there was LF, which is in Go, so faster, but it was a nightmare to set up. And just I discovered yazi a few days ago, and it actually checks all the boxes, and it's also extremely easy to set up and to tinker with. It's quite pleasant, and it's very fast, written in Rust, async.io, and so on. So yeah, so you can install it by just go on their GitHub and find a way to install it on Arch Linux. It's quite easy, just pacman s yazi, if I remember correctly, and then you can launch it by saying yazi. And so yeah, here you can see that the current directory is in the middle. On the right is the preview, and on the right is the upper directory. And you can see that by default it has the vim key bindings, and I mean it's meant to be used with the vim key bindings. So J and K to go up and down, LH to go in and out of directories. You can say, for example, R to rename the something. You can go V to go in visual mode and select multiple things. And then, for example, you can press R again, and then suddenly you're in bulk rename modes. And so you can just prefix everything by four, every file by four, for example. And then it will prompt you to if you want to rename them. And you can see that they're all the rename with four prefix to it. You can, for example, say X and then go in another directory and P to paste. And this is like the cut and paste. Let me put it back there. You can also just D and then delete it, which I will not do for that file. You can see that on the right, there is a preview. For example, this is a long C file. And if I say upper J and K, it will allow me to scroll in this preview. By five lines, and if I go like so if I do, for example, GH, I go home to the home directory as well, and if I can find some next git vids yazi to go back to the directory, you can also press O on the file, and then it will open it in whatever you define to open it. By default, it will open like text file in your editor. It will if I go on a video, when I press O, it
Hey, in
will
this
open
one, I
them in
wanted to quickly
MPV.
present
So yeah,
File
that's another
Manager,
video.
a file
That's the
explorer
current
that
one.
I
That
quickly
looks
that
weird,
I
actually.
discovered.
If and so yeah, you can. So this is O. If you press capital O, it will prompt you like the different options to open a file. And so you can, for example, show the exif, for example. How do I? Oh, okay. What else is there? You can, for example, if you press C on this, oh, you can't really see, but there is plenty of options to copy the file name in different ways. So let's say CC. This will mean that if now I go somewhere and I do paste, it copied the full path. But yeah, there is other options to like a copy without the extension, or copy without the directory, or stuff like that. You can also, just GG and capital G work basically how you would expect. And the thing that really sold me on yazi was the ease with which it did preview for images. So that I tried with other file explorer in the terminal, and it was a pain to set up, like a real pain, and it didn't even work at the end. And for yazi, it has a default integration with Webertsook plus, and so you just install that on Arch Linux. It's quite easy, I think. You just say pacman s Webertsook pp something, and then you just reopen yazi, and all of a sudden just this works flawlessly. And there is yeah it works with every images except the raw images, but anyway, most images work, and that was awesome to see that it could be done. Next, let's go in maybe a bit of my config for yazi. Dot files there, config yazi. So you can see that there is a a few different files that all go in your home directory slash .config slash yazi slash whatever those files are. So yazi.toml is the main one. And so I modified a few things. The first one is the sort order of the file. By default, it's alphabetical, but I prefer sorting my file by the time, so the modified time, and reverse just put the most recently modified at the top. Line mode size is to include like the size of the file on the right. Next, you can change the cache directory. I put something in my home directory so that it will stay persistent between boots. By default, yazi uses like a slash tmp. And so whenever you reboot your computer, your cache will be gone, which is a bit annoying because it will recompute all the thumbnail of the images and so on. That shouldn't bother you. This is for a Git plugin. So yazi also has plugins, although they're in beta, but yeah, they seem to work nicely. So here I have a Git plugin, for example, and the way I install it is if I just do something. This is what you would type in your terminal to install a yazi plugin. You should just say pack and then a and then the GitHub path to it. So I have, for example, installed the Groovebox Dark Theme, and I also installed the Git plugin, as you can see. And so that means that, for example, those little icons, like the crayons icon, means that some files were modified in Git. And so that's how it shows this. Besides that, there is the theme, which is, you can just look at the doc for that. But whenever you install a theme with the package manager, you just say flavor, use, and then the name of the theme. That's pretty easy. By default, it also has those weird rounded corners, which I don't like, so I remove those, but doesn't matter too much. The key maps is also a nice one. So, for example, the gd command, which puts you to your download directory. By default, it's slash uppercase download, like most normal computers, but on mine, I prefer to use just DL, and so I just override that. There is also, I added a shell thing, so whenever I do exclamation mark, it drops me into a shell quickly, then when I exit the shell, it puts me back into yazi. They also have like scriptable things, so they support Lua for the plugins, and you can have your own Lua file, a bit very much like NeoVim, but yeah. And so, for example, here I set up the Git plugin, and then there is a few things to just, for example, here I put in the status bar the user and group of files. So if you see here, if you look at the bottom, oh fuck, it's under my camera. Well, it doesn't matter that much, but yeah, there is at the bottom the owner and the group of the file. And here it says it adds the host name and the username at the top. So if I go back into yazi, you can see that at the top it's Charles at Charles Fractal. Your plugins that you can make custom plugins as well. So if you go in the plugins directory, you need to enter the name of the plugin and then say .yazi and put that as a directory, and then whatever Lua files are in there will be loaded, starting with the init.lua, if I'm not mistaken. And so for example, this is a thing I took from yazi's documentation that allows me to, whenever I do L to enter a directory, if it's a file, it will actually open it, so that, it's a bit easier. What else is there? Oh yeah, you can do drag and drop. So yeah, not by default, unfortunately, so you cannot like drag a file like this. But for example, there is often some web interface like this one, for example, where you need to drag a file into them. Sometimes even they don't have some kind of button where you can click and select a file by yourself. You really have to like literally drag something, which is quite annoying, but it exists. And for that, you can install the Dragon utility, which is just a very simple utility that will allow you to do, for example, I say drag and drop like this with like the star to say all the files. And then what I will see is a list of files here that I can just drag and drop wherever I want. And so to integrate that into Yazi, what I did is I went into the key maps and I mapped this to Control N, and it will create a shell and it will do drag and drop with a few options and put the files that I selected in Yazi as the arguments. And so now whenever I go in visual mode and select a bunch of stuff and then I do Control N, you can see that now I have a bunch of files and I can put that here and then drag this into this, and then probably won't understand it's into an image thing, but doesn't matter, you can drag and drop, it's pretty nice. Next, there is a thing that I saw that I haven't set up yet, but that seems really nice. You can also make Yazi your default file explorer. So this is a XDG desktop portal. So it's a thing like basically if I do, let's say, I don't know, whatever, how do you say, like save as, it will, this is my, for now, my default file explorer for whenever an application needs the file explorer. But you can replace this one by Yazi with this repo, which I will link, and I will need to do that in the future, which allows you to use any terminal terminal file explorer as your default one, which is pretty nice. And so, yeah, I think that's about it. Oh, yeah, I have one last thing to show. So you see that I use Y instead of Yazi. That's because, and you see also that whenever I use Y, so right now I'm in config Yazi, but if I go up in Yazi and then I quit Yazi, you see that my shell also changed. And so that's just quite nice to navigate a bit more easily. And you can do that in the in whatever your shell config is. You can go in your shell's config, and then if I search for function Y, so you can add something like this, which will it's basically a wrapper, a quick little wrapper around Yazi that will remember which path you were in when you were using Yazi, and then whenever you quit it, it will call CD and just put you back in that directory. So that's quite nice. So yeah, that's about all the thing I modified and discovered about Yazi. It's really nice. I think I've made enough compliments about it today, but I should just mention that they have like a tips page, which is awesome, and they have like 50% of what I talked about, like all my customization comes from here, because it's just stuff you kind of would want. So I mean, it makes sense that this is not by default, but it's they have a very thorough description of all the little hacks that you can do with Yazi, and it's really, really nice. Anyway, that's about it for the Yazi File Explorer. I hope you enjoyed it and that you will use this program and have fun with it. And see you in the next one.